Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about the tooth chisel. It's a favorite tool of many sculptors as it can be used both as an intermediary tool as well as a finishing tool because it leaves a beautiful mark on the surface of the stone. I'll start with a description of the chisel, I'll tell you a bit about its purpose, and as usual I'll show you how to use it. Basically, everything you need to know about the tooth chisel. So if you're interested in knowing more about it, let's go and see what they're all about. The tooth chisel is sometimes also referred to as the claw chisel, whereas in Italian it's called the gradina. It's an intermediary tool. It's used after roughing out the stone to remove the rough marks left by the point chisel and to prepare the surface for the finer details with the flat chisel. But it can also be used as a finishing tool because of the vivid marks that it leaves behind. As a matter of fact, many sculptors have decided to use its distinctive texture as a finished surface. Michelangelo, for example, relied heavily on tooth chisels. Very often he left extremely rough marks over large areas of his sculptures. Other times he used them with incredible delicacy to texture the surfaces and to control the play of light. To give you a more recent example, this is a sculpture that I have carved some years ago, where I applied various tooth chisels to achieve this vibrant texture. As with most chisels, it consists of a metal rod of about 20 to 25 centimeters in length, and its diameter varies between 1 and 2 centimeters. What's peculiar about the tooth chisel is the wide range of the width of the cutting edge. As you can see, it can vary between a couple of millimeters in width, and they can go up to 10 centimeters or even more. But it must be said that the wide varieties are usually used only on softer stones. The cutting edge consists of a series of points that resembles a line of teeth. That's why they're called tooth chisels. The number of points on the cutting edge can vary from 2 up to 15 teeth. Their shape can be either pointed or squared. The pointed ones for the rougher work, especially after the use of the point chisel, and the squared ones for the finer details. Tooth chisels come both in hardened steel and carbide tipped versions. The carbide ones are great, but they have a few minor setbacks. The first one is that they're very expensive. They can cost up to 3 times as much as the steel ones. The second issue is that the tips might break or detach while carving. This happens when a sideward pressure is exerted onto them, usually when the chisel is driven into a tight corner and gets stuck. Don't forget that carbide is an extremely hard alloy, but it's also very brittle. To give you an example of this, here are various tooth chisels that I have mishandled during the years. The chisel is usually struck with a hammer or with a round mallet, either in steel or in synthetic fiber like this one. I will do another episode in the future dedicated only to hammers, where I'll explain you all the differences. All you need to know for now is that a round steel mallet like this one might be the most versatile option to use with the tooth chisels. You should hold the chisel at an angle of 30 to 60 degrees to the surface of the stone. With a narrow angle, you'll be able to gently go over the surface of the stone, preparing it for the final stages with a flat chisel. While the wider angle will allow you to remove much more material, but the marks left behind will be rougher. Obviously, also the shape of the actual teeth, whether squared or pointed, will affect the marks left behind on the stone. So this was it for today. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions or any comments, please leave them here below. I'll be more than happy to check them out for you. In the meantime, stay safe, stay home or at the studio, and I'll see you next time.